You know what I think? I think God wakes me up out of my slumber when Drake drops.
Deep.
I really, really do. Because I'll be knocked out. And then I just wake up. And then my hand just like literally goes to my phone to check Twitter. And then it says, Drake drops. I'm like, I promise you that's happened before.
That's the only time the Lord wakes you up.
Yes.
When he doesn't wake you up every day.
He does. I'm saying he wakes me up out of my slumber. Like when it's like wee hours in the morning. You. It was like 3:30 in the morning. Is what I'm saying.
I know that's when it dropped. I ain't see it until I woke
it
up.
It ain't dropped 3:30. It dropped like right before I sent y'all to Jones in the thing. It was at night. It was like
I ain't even, I was
it was like nine. It was like 10 something on Saturday night.
Well, I was asleep before you even sent this.
Now what? Yeah. Now what I just said just sounds dumb.
I mean, nah. You seen it the same.
It's still not before deep
you
anymore.
Would, yeah. That's still normally before you would get up though.
Right.
Yeah, because I was knocked out at that time.
Yeah, that time. Yeah.
I was. It was wild.
Honestly, I was
Saturday night.
Saturday night. Yeah, I was asleep too. I went to sleep like probably 20 minutes after them joints dropped. Like after I sent y'all the joints.
Yeah,
I think I was probably going like 20 minutes to a half hour.
Everybody was trash Saturday night.
Yeah, I don't care.
I'm just going to assume you didn't send me nothing because you assumed that I was already up on it.
Honestly, I did, but I think my I'm like so used to like. I don't know, the group
he
chat
remixing,
we got,
guys.
We just like,
he
send it
he
there.
He's just stuttering.
It's nah,
cool.
Nah.
It's cool. But I was so excited, like I saw Sampha trending, but it's not even him.
It was not Bull.
It was some guy named Givion. What's his
yeah,
name? What's
like,
his name?
I think it's like
Givion. G-I-V-E-O-N. I don't know how
that
to pronounce
it. Sampha.
Yeah, like, no.
It's crazy because that rhymes with Sam.
It's crazy because he sounds just like him. So it's like,
yeah, apparently he's from Long Beach, California.
Oh, I couldn't even tell.
I clicked on his name. Like I was gonna move through life thinking it was Sampha until like I just was happened to be scrolling on my timeline.
It did sound like him.
And he was like, "That's not Sampha, it's me, guys."
Right? You seen that, John?
Yeah. So I clicked on him. And then I clicked on like the little link in his bio and it had like all his streaming platforms that he's presented on. So I heard a quick snippet of, I guess, his most popular song. I was like, oh, okay. But what are the reasons for artists not putting like featuring
On the title.
Like, why don't they always express who's featured on it? Like, why do I have to go through a wild goose chase just to figure out who's singing, who's the person singing on there? And that's happened through history of music.
I think it's, I'm not saying this is exactly why. Mm-hmm. I could just see it being like, what if they got the beat and the vocals is already on it? So for them, it's just a track with a sample on it, but they didn't know that artist actually probably was involved in the beat making process. So when he put it out, it's just a Drake song, but he might not have known offhand. Like even if he did know, he got this beat pre-made with the vocals.
Oh, okay.
And he just added his part.
I can understand that.
Yeah, if that's the yeah,
if that, that's the case,
if but... that's the case, because that does not. Take artists off the hook like Tupac back in the day.
Yeah, I had to say.
Them West Coast artists had that same chick singing on all their tracks.
Yeah.
No one, who was that?
Yo, we don't know who that was. Yo, she probably not even paid.
Like, yeah, then she sang on ring, ding, dong, ring, ding, 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 dong. And
it's ringing.
And who sang on It's the Thuggish Ruggish Bone?
No, it's the same chick.
No, it's the same girl.
It's the Thuggish Ruggish
Bone. Disclaimer, I'm not actually sure that's the same chick, but they was doing that in the West with this chick on their tracks.
Yo, she was just a song hoe. Like, she was just jumping all around. Like, yo, you're not getting your name out there at all.
You need a chorus?
Right.
Got you.
I think, and what's the name? I think they did that too with, matter of fact, they did that on Rich Boy, on Good Things by Rich Boy. Remember Good Things with Polo the Don and Kerry Olsen?
Yeah.
Yo, Usher is on that.
He is on that.
Usher is on that in the background.
Yeah.
His vocals is in the back and he's like ad-lib singing along with the hook with Kerry Olsen.
I have to re-listen
yo,
now.
But it's like, yo, his name nowhere on that song.
it was, if you know whose name is on the song and they're only like, wait, there's this song, is it Castro? And it has Big Sean listed on there. It's like Yo Gotti, Quavo. Here, I have to bring it up.
Yo Gotti, I feel like Quavo. I brought this up before. I remember the title, but I don't remember like how the song goes.
I'm just gonna play a snippet.
Yeah. Wait, I gotta go to the hook.
Yeah, it's on the hook. Wait, hold on, no, no. On the hook and the right when it play in the beginning. No, play it from the beginning. Play it from the beginning. You're gonna hear it.
Right.
Why was this song so fire?
I know. You're going to hear it. You're going to be like, hey. What? Hold up. You're going to hear it right here.
I always heard that. Yo, I didn't know that was Usher, though.
Yes, that's him.
Is he any other part of it?
Yeah, he be like, on other hooks. You can hear him in the background and everything.
Oh, yeah, I do hear that. I remember that voice. I just never equated to being Usher.
Yeah, I actually like read that because I at first when we was listening to it, that was back like, that joint dropped 07. So it's like back then I didn't know, but I read online, like, I mean, in a while later, I was like, yo, it was Usher. And I remember me and J-Mar was even talking. And we was like, at the time before we even knew that, we used to always, because we used to watch that video like on the summertime and everything. Yeah. And we used to be like, yo, who is that other boy? Like, it's another boy in there, but we don't know who it is.
Yeah, I always thought it was just some random boy.
It was a random, right. I'm about to say, that was probably a rich boy doing that or something like that. But
let me find out 13 years later, Usher going to be like, you want to read an article that says, Usher sues rich boy for non-payment for vocals from 07?
Right. That'd be like, dog.
If I was rich boy, I'd be like, yo, you're Usher.
Yeah,
I don't have nothing.
Dude, I don't have anything. I'm rich boy, and I ain't even rich.
I'm just boy now.
Right, I'm just boy.
This is Castro.
Oh, wait, I do remember that.
And this all that Big Sean ever says. That's it.
Wait, is he featured? Is the name on
it? And
it
says he featured on it, and that's all he says. Like, you don't hear anything else from him.
Yeah, that's just like Monster Rick Ross. Yeah. Hold on, and remember, yo, remember.
I think remember, I already know what you're going to talk about.
Tell me what I'm saying. Tell me, please.
The game song with...
actually, no, but go ahead. What game song?
Remember Jesus Peace? Who was at the end? Fab?
Oh, Fab on that lady, John?
Yeah.
And it faded, his voice faded off? No, I was about to say, yo, Will Smith, Party Starter. They keep saying Ludacris is on there. Ludacris is not on there.
It was not on there.
Yo, Ludacris didn't have a verse. He didn't have an ad lib. He didn't have anything. They just put featuring Ludacris. I was like, yo, that was Will Smith the whole time. Like, it was never Ludacris.
There was another song like that, but I can't think of it. Only I always see the video, and it always said, yo.
No, I know what you're talking about.
Well, all right, whatever.
All right, you're about to say R. Kelly. You
know,
Kelly? And it was Big Ticket.
We talking about that, Jerome.
I'm about to say, it was never Cameron. I'm like, dog, it's just another round head bald boy. Like, it's not Cameron.
I want somebody to do an interview with Cam and ask him about that.
First of all, what if Cam was like, well, you know me and Kel, you did the video, you know, you went to the desert, you know, he had the jersey on,
like
Harlem, had the jersey on, Harlem, you know,
145th and Lennox, you know what I mean?
Right, Jimmy was there, you know, Freaky Zeke, you know, we just did the video, you know, Big Tig, he was there with me. But he ain't do my verse, but he was there with me. We're like, what?
Move your body like a snake, ma.
Cameron.
No, R. Kelly. You can't even do that song anymore.
Wow. That's a shame. You know A.O. got the But yeah, back to the actual Drake content. So, I woke up out of my slumber. God woke me up out of my slumber.
God was like, what up, what up, what up? Welcome to the Offscore Cast. I'm Ant.
I'm Jazzy Miotti.
Hey, yo.
And we the plug. Offscore Cast on Twitter. Offscore Cast on Instagram. Offscore. Y'all already know, man. Y'all know.
Yeah.
If you don't know now, you're a first-time listener. So, rewind. Commit all that to memory. Hit us up. Also, offscorecast@gmail.com for to contact us, to send us anything you want to send us, anything we could put out there, any comments we can comment on, any questions we could answer, hit us up. Jasmine, you were saying.
So yes, God woke me up out of my slumber to hear these two Drake tracks. I clicked on the link immediately and was met with Drake's earring that he probably wears now. It just cracks me up. When to say when, Jay-Z samples song Cry, love it. Finally get a the audio for the video.
The nervous Drake video when he was seen
looking back and forth, side to side in front of Marcy's project. Then it transitions into this Chicago freestyle that like caught me by surprise. And I loved it. I loved the feel of it. Everybody thought Sampha was featured on it, but it's G-I-V-E-O-N. I don't want to pronounce his name wrong.
Salt.
And I was still sleepy, so I passed back out immediately after that. So I couldn't wake back up to
get a like a
to listen to it with a clearer mind because I was still foggy. But upon first listen, I was like, I'm gonna keep replaying this. It's the Drake flow that I like, the content that I like.
Right.
So I just been playing both of them, and I think I know which one I like better as of now. Not that I like better, but that I've replayed more. So what about you guys?
I know which one I like definitively better. I know which one I like
better. Yeah, me too.
When to say when?
Honestly, I'm going to Chicago, John.
I'm going with the Chicago one a lot.
I like them both a lot.
Yeah, I know. Me too. Yeah. I like them both. Yeah,
I want to say when lyrically to me.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, yeah, lyrically that, and plus it has more, plus it's longer, but.
When to say when, I mean, Chicago freestyle I like because it sounds more like a, I like the song. It sounds like verse, hook, verse. I like the song of it all. Right. If I got to just break it down lyrically, I like. When to say when.
Breaking it down lyrically, like when to say when, like that's the type of Drake content I like. I like when he talks like that. I like when he flows like that. Right. I appreciate the Jay sample. But I don't know. I guess maybe because I just wasn't expecting Chicago Freestyle. It has more, I guess, replay value, I guess you want to say. Because it is, like you were saying, like the song structure, like it's catchier. Like that G-I-V-E-O-N. Singing, like, I like this. It, I don't know. It makes me feel, like, cold. Like, I want to bundle up. I don't know.
Chicago.
It's like the feel of it. Yeah, it's, like, that reminiscent of the sound that keeps coming from Canada. Like, the Roy Woods and Drake and Party and all them. So... I don't know. I like it a lot. It's making me really excited for whatever Drake is about to put out. I think it's interesting that he doesn't put it on. He's not putting these things on Apple Music. Like he keeps going to SoundCloud and calling them leaks. So what is the purpose of that? Like what's?
I don't know.
Is it marketing? Is it just
some sort of something?
Is it have to do with like legality? Like or
it could have something to do with legality. These could be songs that. It could be a couple of things. It could be songs that he's not looking to make money off of. Like he's just, or
he's just rich.
Let me start over. I'm all over the place. It could be, these could just be Lucy's, like extra songs he's not putting on whatever he's about to put out. So he's just giving it to the streets, essentially. It could be he didn't want to present these as singles, so he's seeing what the reception will be before giving them a bigger platform. It could be a number of things. Those are my two assumptions right now, though.
When does he ever really get, like, bad reception, though? Like, even if the song, like...
The Joe and Khaled.
Oh, yeah, that... No, that was terrible. And that, the Lemonade and remix. Lemonade and the Lemon remix. Those two were terrible.
Yeah, Lemon
remix. Hold on, what Khaled are you talking about?
The terrible one.
The To The Max?
Yeah.
That was horrible. horrible. That's
still my like my I hate that song.
I feel so like betrayed and frauded because they were like the Drake vocals ran.
You thought it was about to be nuts. Like, yeah, like who when cares? When that dropped, even I was to it, I was like, this
it was nuts. I thought it was
me. I was like, right. I think me and you talked about it. I thought it was me. I was like, I don't like this joint. He was like, y'all don't like it either. And then that was the first time I went on Twitter and everybody was like, nah.
It's like, I can't really remember how it sounds right now. But it sounds like mumbo jumbo in my head. Like, I remember it was a lot going on and it didn't make sense. So I don't ever want to revisit that again. But other than those two, like, when Drake puts out stuff, like, he knows what's going to hit. Like, this is a sound that everybody loves from Drake, to be honest. So I just hope it's the same feel for the album, because that would be dope if he did that. I mean, I enjoyed everything. Like, people acting like all of a sudden they don't enjoy Scorpion. I enjoyed it. I'll still go back to it.
What, Scorpion?
Yeah.
Y'all don't be going back to Scorpion, yo. I don't know what it is. I mean, I like Scorpion. I just don't.
Revisit it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like, not anymore. Like, I'll revisit it. Like, came out 2018. I would go revisit it again in 2019 and stuff sometimes, but I don't know. I'll be going back to all his other albums now. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I'm ready for another one.
Yeah, another project. I'm definitely
ready for another one.
Like, so I'm confused. Like, is Drake coming before Future and Drake? Is Future and Drake ever coming?
I'm thinking Future and Drake isn't coming.
I don't think they're coming. Well, why would you lead us on?
Because they know you'd be led on.
I'm about to say, they know what they're doing.
All that's going
to
do is help Future with his rollout.
I don't care.
Because Life is Good was his, too, so. I mean.
Maybe they're doing a double disc.
I hope not.
But what, like a double disc together or one Future album with a Drake album attached to it?
I don't want that.
Maybe it's a Drake album and then a blended Future, and maybe it's a triple.
No. They better not. That is a bad idea. That is a horrible idea.
It is a horrible idea, but maybe that could be what they're doing.
I hope not.
What are they doing? Let me know.
I think Future's going to drop and then Drake's going to drop.
But there's not going to be a union? What?
If there is another one, I think they're going to drop solo first at the very least.
Oh. I think one of them going to drop solo first. Who? Because Future just dropped the album. All right, this is what I think.
Future is dropping, yo. I don't have any proof. He's dropping. Like, the way they rolled that out for him, and then he did the remix, and there was no Drake on it. And, like, I think Future's coming. I think we're due for a Future album.
He's all in love, so Life is Good is going to be the only song y'all like.
He did. See, Future dropped an album last year that ain't really getting no love, but
exactly, which is why he got to come back and drop again, because he dropped shit.
He's in love now. So the only song on there y'all gonna like is Life is Good. It's gonna be all these power.
And no, I'm not gonna be mad at that, because Hendrix was crazy. If he dropped Hendrix too, which I heard he's dropping, I'd be happy.
But that backs
okay,
that
stop
backs
pointing
up.
At me.
I know. I was like, Hendrix, Hendrix.
Nah, but that's my second. That adds to my point, because I think this whole Lori Harvey thing. You don't think that's also going to be used to fuel Future's, like, to keep the spotlight on? Future's coming, yo.
I still don't care. I only care about Future if it's attached to Drake. Like, I need a Future.
Yeah,
and
I'm not even the biggest Future fan, but from what I'm just seeing of how they're rolling him out, I think he's gearing up.
I think he's bubbling, though. All right.
Drake is clearly trying to build excitement for himself.
Yeah, Drake is coming. I just want to know, like, the whole, like, if desires thing and the whole.
I think Future's gonna come if they drop solos and no joint album. I think Future is gonna come first with the way I see them maneuvering right now. It looks like Future's gonna drop, then Drake's gonna drop. Because Drake seems like he's testing the waters right now. We don't have any definitive Drake track right now. He's just been giving us these Lucy's and leaks.
Then the unions come in, then they're going on tour.
I can see that. But I could also see them just dropping two solo albums and then touring together.
And then just performing their solo stuff together.
Because they already... because then if they do a duo, I would drop it... Oh, they need to have me as a manager. I would drop Future... I would have Future drop, then Drake drop, and they both should have a song with each other on each other's albums. They should tour and then drop the duo album while touring.
And perform.
Because the spotlight is already super on them. That is the perfect way to do it. You'd have maximum eyes on you while you're touring.
So why don't you link up with them and like give them these ideas? I
mean, you're right. Ayo Future and Drake, just hit me up. You know the number. You don't, but hit up auxcorecast@gmail.com.
Yeah. So do you
watch we get a DM or email tonight? Or well, not tonight. Well, once
when
we drop.
Once we drop.
Yeah.
Do you think that one person would pull eyes away from another if they drop separately?
I think they have.
Or you think they have equal?
I think they have. I don't want to say they have two different fan bases.
Because if. Yeah, because if it's like if Future drops first and then Drake drops, do you think Drake's like fan base will kind of, or do you think the attention of Drake will kind of just pull people away from the Future album and just stay at
no,
the Drake?
Because
no,
because they can't think. Well, I mean, they can't. I don't want them to drop on the same day or anything.
No, I mean, not on the same day, but I mean, like, even
I think they should at
Future's
least be.
Future's not affecting Drake.
I feel like.
Right. I don't think that either.
No, Drake has the larger pool. I think we can just.
I feel
he's
like
a worldwide.
Drake got to drop first, yo.
There's Future
no,
fans that are Drake fans. There are more Future fans that are Drake fans than Drake fans that are Future fans.
I can agree with that.
I think.
I'm being one of
you. Said you think Drake got to drop first?
I only say that because I can see Future. I mean, I understand, like, I may be wrong. And I understand that if they had, like, they kind of come as, like, a. Package sometimes. So it's like if they have songs with each other on each other's albums, all right, that can help as far as like the attention getting pulled away from one and onto the next. I only said maybe Future could drop first because if he drops first. No. If Drake drops first, I feel like people will go to. No. I said Drake got to drop first. Yeah. I think Drake have to drop first because if Future drops first, I would think that more people would leave Future's album to just go and listen to Drake albums, and more people will go back and revisit if Drake would have dropped first to that album.
Does it matter because we all have Apple Music and we can just make a playlist?
I mean, well, I guess we can. No, I guess I'm just thinking about
both
of
them. You just drop them like a month. Music doesn't live that long unless you're a certain caliber of artist. And even then, music does not live with people long enough to make a difference.
Anymore.
So I say you give them 3 weeks to a month. Let Future drop middle of April.
Mm-hmm.
Let Drake drop top to the middle of May, because you know Drake got ahead of summer. So you let either one of them get ahead of summer, but I would give Drake the summer. Like, let Drake drop in May. That's enough time. Future will be, he'll have his couple of weeks, which is the longest music lasts in the public consciousness now anyway. He'll have a couple of weeks going crazy.
Right.
Drake will drop. He'll have his couple of weeks going crazy. They tour for the summer because that will be the craziest summer tour for both of them.
All right. If they tour for the summer, that changes things. If they tour for the summer.
I mean, that's all hypothetical. I'm not sure. Right. I don't know they're going to do that.
I know what I'm saying. That kind of changes what I was... Because I was thinking about it as if they weren't going to tour after that. Like, if they just dropped them and then that was... They probably did their separate things or... But if they definitely tour during the summer, oh, yeah. And I can't see any one have an effect on the other either. Like, at all.
Then if they did drop the joint in the summer, now you getting eyes and you making money while you make money while you release music all at the same time.
They gonna have a whole year.
I would be sitting back as their manager like, oh, we making it's yeah. They have the year at that point.
At that point, yeah.
Then once I drop, it's really gonna shake them.
Well, right. they probably tour gonna get canceled once you drop.
Everybody, everything is just done once they drop.
It's gonna be
really shake the room.
Jazzy Miotti is the headliner and. Doja Cat opens for you.
Right.
Oh my God.
Exactly.
Tell me why I really played myself today. I was posting the promo for the podcast and I tagged Doja Cat in the interlude and I saw like it light up. Doja liked it. And then I'm like, oh my God, it said Doja Attic. I was so mad. It's like a fan page. I almost had a heart attack. I was like,
Yo, that would have been crazy. Yeah, that would have been wild.
Oh my God, I was so mad. Like, oh, Doja Addict.
That's something.
Whoever you are, Doja Addict, you just ruined everything.
Right.
It's like, no.
Or she brought ass to show love.
It's like, well, no, thanks. Yeah. It could, I don't know, it could lead to Doja Cat. Who knows? But speaking of shaking the room, did y'all see that? Excuse me. 50 Cent volunteered to finish Pop Smoke's album. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
I think I'm not mad at it.
You think he's chasing the bag? I thought it was genuine.
I don't think he's chasing the bag. I think 50 wouldn't have done this if so many people didn't
make comparisons.
Make comparisons and give 50 kind of credit for Pop Smoke's vibe, style, or whatever.
Yeah, because you know what? And before
if
they, you...
So honestly, if there was someone to do it, I understand why it's 50 Cent. That's why I'm not mad at it.
And you know what? After all this talk, I can say. Because I remember before when you were saying, you sound like 50. I was like,
They thought I was crazy here on the podcast when I said it initially. All right,
Jazz, we...
Because his voice is a little bit more raspy. We give props to Jazz. But as I heard, I was like, You know what did it for me after we talked about it, after we came at Jazz about it?
I watched one of his freestyles, and I was like, he do kind of sound like 50. Yeah, sound like 50, yo.
Rest in peace, my guy. Yeah, he do.
50 just doing anything, trying to finish his album. You heard he took that Def Jam job?
I thought that was a rumor.
He put up a status saying he was taking it.
Yeah, but I thought that was him playing.
Oh, he played with that?
That's what I heard. I don't know if that's... I don't know anything.
I mean, I saw it, but I didn't... I heard about the tweet.
What did the tweet say?
It said... I literally just looked at it on the way over here, actually. It was like... I think I'm going to take the job as a chairman or whatever. It was a picture of him looking over his balcony or whatever. And he was just like, yeah, I think I'm going to take the job over at Def Jam. And he was just like, somebody got to do it, so why don't it be me? Or something to that effect.
I just can't hate 50 him.
50 trolls so much. It's like, I don't know. The only reason I say that is because the Def Jam job has been a joke. Not a joke as in whoever takes the job is a joke. Right. But people clown that position so much now that it's like, are you serious? Or is it just an internet troll? Like,
it's hard to like not like 50 for some reason. For me, it's hard to like hate him. Like, I don't know, maybe I respect him. I don't know.
Well, you gotta respect him.
Yeah, I feel like he's disrespectful to people a lot, but I don't know if I take it seriously. Like, I don't like his back and forth with Taraji. Like, I don't like that whole thing, but I don't know. I really think he's playing and he's just going too far.
I think it's because
I don't know.
50 is like the bully, but at the same time,
he's so intelligent. Like, when he speaks,
yeah, it's like when you want to hate him, you can't knock his hustle because he just switches up his hustle so constantly and then constantly wins.
Yeah.
Like, from obviously the streets to rap. And then he revolutionized the mixtape game with all them G-Unit mixtapes and 50 Cent mixtapes.
He's a definition of a winner.
A diamond first album.
Then, yeah, what's the name? You heard the Massacre just went. Massacre. And they showed like a top and bottom his first two albums, like both of them, Jones went like, I think, what was it?
The first one was Diamond.
Get Rich was like nine times. Yeah, Diamond. And then The Massacre was like six times. I don't know. It was something crazy.
That's my thing. So he did that. He conquered that. Then he was in a movie. Then Vitamin Water on top of everybody under him and G-Unit going platinum.
G-Unit clothing.
Then he... We don't even got power.
Right.
Then he got the show on ABC now.
And he had
Did we say vitamin water? F and vodka.
Yeah, okay, well, I mean.
Come on, man. You got to get F.
He did have F. He had a vodka. But it's like, he's just killing it. You kind of got to respect it.
Yeah, you're right.
He's a bully, but clearly he knows what he's doing behind closed doors.
Mm-hmm.
Even though he's very strategic and like he's about business, I really do think, I like to think in my mind, my heart, that he's just doing it just for love. The love that he was showing or beginning to show Pop Smoke and like for New York. That's what I would like to think. I don't know if it's so much of a business move.
Nah, he's a businessman. Yeah. I'm not saying that's not true, but he's definitely a good businessman.
He'll benefit, but like, I didn't think of it as like, oh, this sleazeball. Like, well, yeah, I didn't think about it.
I don't think he's doing things that he doesn't actually have passion for or want to do.
Because in that case, he probably could have done a whole lot of things in the past.
Yeah, because I saw people commenting on it like, oh, here he go. Like, would you have done this if he would? I mean, he wouldn't have to because he would be alive.
Right.
Like,
yeah, right.
Like, but I don't know. I thought that was pretty dope, in my opinion.
That's what they showing
hopefully
him
he
love.
Keeps his word.
Yeah,
hopefully he's not just trolling. He continues it.
I'm a fan of. I was telling my mom, like, I'm really like a fan of what 50 does. I was like, yo, nothing can have me. I said besides sports, yeah, nobody can have me watching TV, yo. It wasn't until Power started coming on. I was like, for years, I'm like, yeah, I've been stuck to this joint. I'm looking forward
even
to this next show.
Even when it gets corny, you gotta watch it.
Yeah, I'm watching it. And even that next show he about to put out, that For Life, I'm gonna watch that too. It just seemed like
it's already
stuff
out.
That he does. It started?
Yeah. And people saying it's good.
Yo, I ain't even know.
I heard
oh,
it was good.
I'm definitely about to
I
watch it.
I think it's
it.
Only like two episodes out or something like
oh,
that.
Oh, I ain't even, man, I'm about to be right on that joint. But anything he do, like, I just wanna.
We don't play that.
I wanna watch it.
We don't play that G.
We don't play that. We was listening to 50 and G for the last like week. Mm-hmm. So. Yo, I definitely respect everything he's doing. You seen he had you seen Pop Smoke had a hologram, right?
No.
Yeah,
you see that? Yo, they got
like
a hologram
Russia or
in a club.
England or somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere over there. They had he the only other one after like Pac or.
No, there was somebody else.
I'm about to say, wait, it was somebody else in between. But hey, they had a hologram Pop Smoke in the club over there.
Oh my God, I would probably be scared. I'd probably start crying.
Yo, he was shaking the room.
I can't believe that.
Holographically.
Yeah,
shaking
right.
the room.
Exactly, yo.
God.
Hologram.
No. But what was I about to say? Oh, yeah. You even love 50 after A.O. Technology?
A.O.
I didn't even mean
technology.
But,
right. Listen. He got to delete that, all right?
A.O. Technology. Nah, you got your remix.
A.O. Technology. You are now A.O. Technology, yo.
A.O. Tech.
No,
A.O. Tech.
A.O. Tech. Yo.
I didn't mind. Everybody was like making fun of or acting like they didn't like A.O. Technology. I love that joint.
Yeah.
No, she with their hands.
That song was trash.
Dog, that joint was not
Yo hips, yo thighs, they got me hypnotized. Yo hips, yo thighs. That's
why.
That's what Simba
said. I know, but like, yo, for what? No, that was, yo, honestly, that was not 50, yo. That sound, that was not 50. It wasn't. It wasn't him.
It was technology.
Yo,
no.
Just damn.
Yeah, no, like, no.
Timba's damn. Damn.
Yo, just damn. Damn. Yo. No, dog. I'm not giving it to him.
Something special.
Unforgettable. 50 Cent. Just damn.
No.
Timberland.
He tried to rhyme
God damn.
50. He tried to rhyme Cent with just
stin. No. Cent with stin. With land. No, dog. He not getting that, yo. I'm sorry. 50 not getting that, yo. Yo.
Yo.
Nah, he is not getting it, yo. I'm sorry. A.O. Technology will not get it.
A.O. Technology,
of, no.
A. Nah. Electronica.
Yo, no. Oh, no.
A.O. Electronica.
No.
Speaking of, nah, I did go back to, no, I went back to Port of Miami 2 today. Port of Miami 2.
Mm-hmm. He wasn't getting that. He's still not.
Yo, that joint's still fire to me.
Yo,
Fascinated, come on, like, I gotta turn it up.
Yo,
I
that meatloaf, man, listen.
Do y'all Loves understand that part that I have to turn it up at? Where after, like, the beat really dropped, had me standing in the rain, whatever he say. Never been the same, now I'm getting stacked. Like, I have to turn it up at that point. Like, my finger has to go like this. Like, I have to. And then I'll be so irked when I have my phone connected to the GPS and then
thought it stopped
Siri
and lowered.
Voices rises as I want the song to rise. I'm just like, start it over.
Yo, you gotta start that joint over, yo.
Yeah, I love that song. That song in Vegas Residency. Like, I just.
Yo, I gotta go back to that. I'm mad. I ain't go back to that album as much as I want, as much as I thought I would have been going back.
Cause we anticipated so much.
Yeah.
But But you think Ross is chilling on that for a minute, or you think he's coming out anytime soon, or we give him another 2 years?
I don't know, man. He dropped the D-Wave.
I'm about to say, yo, him and D-Wave right got this EP. No, but
yo, that song was funny.
I don't know. Let me see. Ross dropped. That was last year.
Yeah.
Nah, I don't think he's dropping this year. I think he's gonna have like tracks drop throughout the year, but I don't think he's gonna have.
Do you think he'll be featured on Drake's new album?
I could see it. I mean, I don't know.
You know what? No. I don't say, like, he ain't had Ross on a project since, like, Take Care. I don't think he's going to do it. I mean, not to say that
they
don't have respect.
Golden Roses?
Yeah, but I don't see.
Which was awkwardly placed on Drake.
I see Drake being on
Miami
more
too.
Of Ross's albums than Ross being on Drake's albums. That's what I see.
Drake doesn't really do features that much, does he?
And if he does, you got like people that sound. He got like Sampha and Givion and yeah, more like people randoms. That sound like Sampha. Like, so in division and
Drake featuring Sampha too.
Yeah.
I'm just fiending. Like, I want to know like what the album's going to sound like. But I'm not going to keep dwelling on Drake. My girl Janae is going on tour and her album dropping March 6th.
And her song drops.
I don't think.
Oh, yeah.
The whole joint?
Yeah. I haven't heard it.
Yeah, that joint, all right. Yo, I ain't. You know what? I'm hype. I'm actually hype about this Janae album. Somebody posted something on Instagram. I don't even know if it's new or not. All I know was Janae, and I was like, yo, this is probably one of the toughest Janae songs or clips I've ever heard, but I don't know what it was.
They was at the party?
No, it was just in the car listening to it. And I was like, yo, I don't know what this is. But it just made me look forward to her album, though.
Really excited. She's coming to Philly June 20th.
June 20th?
Yeah, I hope I'm able to make it. I've never been to a Janae concert before. But I really do love her music. My Pisces sis, same birthday. I'm so proud. I don't know why.
Oh, that's her birthday, too?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
March 16th.
That's crazy. Yeah. I didn't know that.
She has her song 316. She's always referencing 316.
True, so, as she should.
I'm excited for that. I feel like Janae is kind of getting more recognition. You feel?
Right now, I think so. Yeah, I think so. She always been getting love, but it seems like this time I feel like a different level of hype than.
Yeah, I feel like I think her relationship with Big Sean, I think that has a part to do with it. Only because it just brings more attention to the content because she's inspired by real life events and where she is in life. So I think not because I don't want it to seem like, oh, y'all only paying attention to her because she dating Big Sean. No, it's because she implants all of that into her music.
Right.
And you're curious. It's like. And she seems so, like, just raw with it.
Yeah.
Unless it's all a fluke and they're just...
Playing around.
Playing around. But I know Big Sean is coming. Like, I know because I watched the pull-up.
I just want to ask you. You saw the pull-up interview?
Yeah, I saw the pull-up. I still haven't finished it. Like, because I've just been so busy. But I've just been watching it a little bit at a time.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, I just... It was normal for me because it's like, I always knew Big Sean was like this and... That's part of the reason why I love them. Like, I like when he speaks. Even though he kind of, like, drags his words and stuff like that. Like, I still... Mm-hmm. I like what he has to say.
I like that interview. That pull-up interview was good.
Yeah, it was a really good interview. And because I listened to his Joe's podcast, I know that he was... I would get so angry, too, because I'm like, what does he have against Big Sean? Because, you know, I love Joe Budden, but, like, he would always be, like, grinding him up. I'm like, ugh. Mm-hmm.
But, well, because Joe was a hater first.
Yeah.
And then now he loves him. Like,
he does
so
it every
funny.
Time.
He does every
it's
time.
So
every
funny.
Time.
Yeah, it's so funny. But
he like hard to impress type boy.
Yeah.
But he's not, though. He just
hates to hate.
He just is an old man. He's just a hater. And then when he meets them, he's immediately.
Yeah, he loves them immediately. I love it. It's so funny. But yeah, that was a good. I didn't see it, but I saw the preview for his next pull up, not the one with Wale, with Lil Baby. And I'm like, what is he saying? I was like,
I ain't watched that one yet.
I don't watch
it. I seen the preview.
Clip. I'm like,
it came out Sunday. I ain't watched it.
I was like, what did he just say?
But see, Joe is an admitted Lil Baby fan. So I get why he interviewed him.
Yeah,
plus, his album came out.
Yeah, I listened to his album, yo.
What?
I I wish I could take that face and just have a picture, but
oh, I don't know. No. What face did I make? I don't even know.
It was like that, like, really? So, yeah, like, it was something. But y'all, little baby.
Maybe.
That's really what it is,
And I heard the same thing when he talked. Like, yeah. Joe asked him a question about the baby.
Oh, yeah, about the beef or the beef people tried to make him have.
And I didn't know the answer. I didn't understand. I'm like, so what did he just say? Anybody? Can anybody interpret?
Because people with him is like, he one of them like interviewers, like, you ever see them interviewers that look? They like look around like too much and don't really talk. They just like, well, you know, people just like, I'm supposed to be with me. I'm saying, I ain't with one. When I'm not pull my style, like, you know, I'm showing my baby on baby. Yeah, baby. That's my dog.
What?
you know how people, yo, that is how he talk.
I know what you mean.
Yeah, it's just, that's how a little baby, I don't know.
I was surprised that he had chosen him for an interview.
As soon as I saw it, I was like, that's obvious.
It's crazy. I want to watch it because I told you the other day. I could tolerate him. I could tolerate little baby. I think his.
I don't have anything against him. I can't.
Yeah, his album wasn't. It's crazy. It wasn't as hot as I. All right, it wasn't what I thought it would be, but it wasn't like it was okay. I just feel like it was going to be better because of the stuff that he, like the features that he be having and some of the stuff he has is like.
I was ready to turn it on, turn that album on, and then I asked you how was it, and when you told me that, I was like, well, never mind. And I didn't turn it on.
I know, man, because I was like, when I listened to it at home, I was like.
I'll take your word.
Damn, man.
You tell me it's hot.
I know, but I couldn't. I couldn't just straight up be like, yo, that's not hot. I was like, nah, I can't. I can't lie.
Because
like
if you think it's good, I'll listen to it. But since I'm already like, I wasn't like huge fan already, if you show me like, I'm like, well, then if you think like that, then I know I'm not going to like it.
Because I didn't revisit it. Like, my favorite song on there is probably like, I mean, he got a joint on there with Moneybag, yo, I like. He got a joint on there with Future, I like. And Whoa, I'm always like, Whoa. So that's just.
I don't even know.
Yeah, I'm about to say, I don't even know what song that is.
Y'all heard Whoa.
Well, I probably did. I don't know.
I'm a nigga, not me, Whoa. Matter of fact.
You heard Whoa.
That sounds catchy.
I probably did.
Don't get frustrated. I might have.
Well, no, that's just
he
me
pounding
being,
the.
That's just me. Yo, you heard
he
Whoa.
He pounding the island.
Yo, listen, you heard Whoa, man. You heard it.
No. What did Summer Walker do to her face?
I don't know.
What the nose
face?
Thing?
Yeah. Why does she do that? About it even look loop. Like she got her cheeks. Done. Why does she do that? I don't know.
She got her cheeks done?
She got something.
Like her butt lift. Cheeks or her face
no.
cheeks?
Well, she, well face cheeks. We know she got her butt and her boobs done. She already admitted that. Whatever. But, like, don't touch your face, mamas.
Man, listen.
Michael Jackson knows.
I never thought, I mean.
Love me, you, Michael Jackson. Rest
me personally, I never. I mean, I'm not saying she should have got work done. Like, I was never, like, a fan of, like. A fan of her appearance, like her face. Oh, I was like, yeah, she. All right, I guess.
I thought she was pretty. Like, I feel like a lot of times she goes out her way to, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like I'm not a fan of, like, all the face tattoos and stuff like that. But, like, amidst all that, I thought she was a cute girl. Like, I really did. But it just looks strange. Like, she looks like all like one of them people, like one of them Hollywood people.
That just
like
switched
that
all
get,
up.
That get everything. And then, like, she getting makeup that's not blending in. Like, that's lighter than the rest of her body.
Yeah, see, that ain't cool. I don't like that. Because I haven't even.
I don't
want to
accuse her of
bleaching or anything. I saw the nose thing, but I ain't really been keeping up with, like, what she like looking like. Every day?
Yeah, I just saw it today. I'm like, what's going on? At first, like, when I would see her look like that, I thought it was just, like, makeup or something. But I'm like, oh, no. That's, I don't know. She puzzles me. Because it's like, she just didn't strike me as a person that would even get her, like, body done. Like, she just didn't strike me as that type of person. She just strike me as a person that, like, this is what it is. Like, I am who I am. Yeah. Like, I'm not even trying to be seen. Like, I'm just trying to give you the music. Because I feel like for a minute, she was kind of taking, like, the her type of approach. Like, I didn't know what she looked like for the longest time.
You didn't at first.
But now, like, I don't know if it has to do with, like, the relationship, the high-profile relationship she's in with London. Like, I don't know. It's just, I don't
know. Is that high profile?
They might say, I don't know if that's
high. Well, I feel like they help each other's personas out a little bit. Like, help their celebrities respect.
If anything, I thought they was more, like, I respected their relationship because it seemed, like, lower key than the old other relationships in the industry.
Mm-hmm. Maybe because I follow them, so I always see them, like, together.
That's understandable, too, though.
Yeah, it was kind of like,
I don't know.
It was kind of disappointing to see, like, only because, like, I mean, do whatever you want with your body, I guess, but I just always feel plastic surgery, like, I don't know. I just always feel like it's never really needed on your face. Mm-hmm. Like, if you want to enhance your breasts, like, whatever. The butt thing, I never really was a fan of.
Yeah.
But it's just disappointing. And to be so young, like,
how old
you're
she
already
even?
Right and tight. Like, she's like 23.
Yeah, she might say, I know she's young.
Yeah, but. And it's like, it must really, it's scary. I don't know. The thought of Hollywood really scares me because, like, what be going on? Like,
because it be know like you
people that just seem like real cool, down to earth, regular, and then they become famous, and it must really like mess with your mind.
I mean, people will say, like, even like over time, if you hear interviews, or you just hear anything, people will say like, "Yo, Hollywood is a crazy place." Like, some people don't even like to, or they regret getting to that level, and some people don't even like being in the mix like that because it's like you see so many things, and these people that you see that's like out in the forefront, mm-hmm. or just people that they show you, it's like it's so much stuff just in the back that you don't even know that's going on that can like really change people's lives, that people get caught up in and stuff.
Yeah.
That's why people just start switching up.
Yeah, and you do hear a handful of people say, like, yeah, I don't stay in Hollywood all the time. Like, I have to go back home, like, keep myself grounded and stuff like that. I'm like, what is going on? Like, this gets kind of deeper. I was just thinking, like, as much as I want, like, the podcast to take off and, like, I've always, like, wanted to be a part of the music industry. Like, I've grown up just wanting to be a part. Never really knew how I could fit in. Mm-hmm. But, like, with the surgence of podcasts and blogging and stuff like that, like, I found a place where I could possibly, like, get in there.
Right.
But just the thought of being in the music industry, like, kind of scares me now. Like, just being an adult now and just, like, hearing and being able to understand, like, people's accounts and their experiences in the industry. Mm-hmm. And, like, my personality is not even conducive to that. Like, I don't know. I'm not a super, like, bulldog, trying to knock doors down and be this whole superstar. Like,
you trying to be good. Chilling. Yeah, I was about to say, you trying to chill, but you trying to be good, but you ain't trying to, like,
be all crazy. I'm trying to be on, like, J. Cole's wave, like, just highly respected, but low key.
Right.
Delivers great content and can just fall back and resurge when I'm ready.
Like, yeah, like, that's
type
perfect.
Time. Like that's the type of time I would be on personally because I can't. No, I don't know. I just can't imagine myself. Who knows? Because I'm not in there. Like, being around a whole bunch of people or being in Hollywood and being like, yeah, I gotta get back to surgery. So I can look like every other B-word in this party.
Yeah,
like,
nah.
No.
Not trying to do that, dog. Nah.
I could die. Like, people literally die from cosmetic surgery. So I'm cool.
I think it's a scary feeling. And, like, it's a scary thought, actually, when you think about, like, you know how we, at the level we at now, we'd mm-hmm. be like, see the things some famous people do. And we'd be mm-hmm. like, man, if I was famous, I'd never do that. But it's scary mm-hmm. to think, like, yo, we're not living like that. So it's like, yo, what? Like, that's what really happens? A possibility. Yeah. Like, what happens when somebody give you all that money and all that? And it's like, do you know? Like, you could look at somebody with, like,
peer pressure,
8 chains on your neck, and be like, yo, I never do that. And be
industry
like,
pressure does it,
right?
But you gotta be. I think you just need to be strong willed and have a good team around you.
Yeah.
To where that if that's not something that you wouldn't normally do, you got people like that's not you. Don't.
Yeah, because, and I really, it's crazy. I'll stand by this forever, yo. I really don't see me being one of them dudes that's like, now that I got money, I got to go get me. Like, if y'all know me, like, I wear that one, like, little gold joint with the cross on. That joint is not like all the, it was not a lot of money. That joint is not all iced out creep. But it's like, if somebody was, if I get famous, somebody be like, nah, man, you need to get the, you need to get this bust down watch, and you need to get chain, and you need, I'd be like, bust down. Nah, because I don't want nothing, right? I don't want nothing that's going to bring too much attention. Attention on me. Like, I don't want nothing like that. And I feel like that's not even,
that's why I understand, like these up and coming artists who go and do all of that, you already famous, so you're already a target.
Right.
So then you're going to throw all that on too?
To make you even more of a target. Like, the joint, the circle just getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
Wait, speaking of target, so he's saying that. So over the weekend, like, y'all know I don't really like my car. Like, it's not really super reliable, and I'm always like a nervous wreck when I'm driving it. Mm. So, like, I'm thinking it's time that I get a new car. So, I took my parents with me because I literally know nothing about cars, like, right, at all. So I needed to have people there that are knowledgeable. So I went to some dealerships and I was just looking at some things, like familiarizing myself with the types of cars that are out there. And I was just trying to make the point that, like, I don't want to be super, like, flashy or anything like that. Like, I just want the basic, like, car that's reliable, that'll get me from point A to B, that got a lot of miles. Like, I want to be able to, because I'll be traveling and stuff like that. So, like, it, the car salesman was like, okay, this is the SE model. I didn't even know what SE stood for, so right, it means sports, apparently. Sports model. And then my parents were like, oh yeah, like, why don't you get the sports model? Like, that definitely looks better. And I'm just like, and I was looking at, I was in like the Toyota whatever dealership. So I'm saying to my dad, I'm like, no, like, I don't want to be a target. Like, I want to just be,
you want to be normal, because
it's crazy
regularly
out here. And then my dad's like, first of all, you're not going to be a target driving in a Toyota Corolla.
I can't lie. I was thinking that. I was like, you're not a target.
See, Toyota, yeah, Corolla. I was like, see how much I know? Like, yeah. Yo. Look at me. I don't want to be a target. Like, a sports model. They're like,
yo, I don't know.
Trust me, you're not. Yo, I was cracking up. So while you were saying that, I was thinking about that.
It's real.
But like,
but I see what you were saying. I see what you had with
that's
that
where
though.
My
you
head is at though. Right. It's like, because I heard crazy stories. Like, I think my little clunker that I have now is safe. Actually, somebody did break into that joint, but was salty because there was nothing in there.
Yo, salt. I did not know that.
Literally
happened.
Nothing. Yeah, right in front of my house. I was so earned. Like, excuse me?
Like, of your place now? Oh, I was about to say, I'm like,
no.
What?
No. But I'm like, huh? Like, salty kid, wasn't nothing in there. I don't keep anything in my car. But yeah, that's where my head is. Back to our what we were talking about. Yeah. Are you fearful of, like, what could happen, like, if you enter the music industry? Like, as you got
older.
Not
in my position. Oh. Because I'm not an artist. You know what I mean? Like,
well, true.
That's not to say that, you know, anything can happen to anybody.
Right.
But I think there's a big difference in getting into the industry, even though we've been doing industry-esque work for a while. But I think there's a big difference between breaking through to the music industry or the media industry and when you're younger than it is when you're like, I'm about to be 34. So it's like, yeah, me getting in now is like, well, I got like a kid. Like, I'm not going to be wild now. Like,
yeah, right.
It would be as backwards for me to get in there now and be flashy. I would look nuts. I would look like this old wash guy. They're like, what the fuck?
Like, yeah, like,
you're not old though.
I don't think I'm old, but by comparison to a fresh artist, they'd be getting on at like 17.
To the young industry eye, they would have been like, yeah, he an old head.
Like, I'm not an artist, but if I was an artist, I should have got in my early 20s.
Right.
Like, people who are my age now are well, there's like Drake and Meek, and that would have been my class if I were hanging in. They're my age.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Now, everybody's career and trajectory and journey is different. I'm not saying I have to do it like they did. I'm just saying that like I can't, like I can't do what the younger artists are doing. I don't
want
to do that.
You don't even want to. That's not true. What about Griselda? Aren't they older?
Very true, but they're also an anomaly. Like, you know how, like, and they're just bars.
Yeah, I'm about to say they ain't even like the same wave as like the younger. They're not even like, honestly, to a lot of the artists, like the most popular artists now, they not even like in the current like wave of rap. Like they lucky that they even really getting eyes on them right now, to be honest, with the kind of music that they doing. That's like a blessing right now, because they ain't really getting it.
My brain.
And it's crazy because they can rap. Yeah. Like
they can really rap.
I love it. I love it.
They're
love
like
it.
New age, like Lox, G-Unit.
They like, remind me of like Wu-Tang. Like, well, the one bull, like he remind me of like Raekwon and Ghostface and all them. Tell Virgil right brick on my brick. Yo, I love that song. Yo, I like that. I like that vibe.
Yeah, I might say that vibe is always going to be cool.
Blow your face off. Blow your face off. Blow your face off.
Shout out to Griselda, because I really like them. I think like I need to do a little bit more research on like their projects. I haven't heard them all.
Me too.
But every time I see them freestyle, every time I'm like, yo, these dudes can rap.
Yeah,
yo.
Even like Royce showing them love and stuff like that. Like that was like,
yeah.
I say, I was like, so that was what's hurt up. At Rolling Loud that I had that whole chicken wing box and fries in my hand, because I would have really been closer to the show.
What did you say, Griselda?
Yeah, like I was so far back and like. I could easily like be on the stage down there because nobody was really near their set, and I'm like, does nobody else hear this fire? Like I wasn't really, nice. I didn't really like know too much about them, but I kept hearing like their name. So Rolling Loud actually turned out to be a great experience for me because it put me on to some people.
Right.
Got me more interested in some people.
I like that question you posed because, all right, so how would you operate if you got in?
Yeah, I was saying that just with everything, just as I've been getting older and getting more privy to like how things operate and how dirty the business really is, I don't know if my personality, the way I am, is conducive to that type of environment. So I don't know how I would really like thrive, but. Right. To your point, like I wouldn't be an artist, so I'm kind of looking at everything from like reporting on the music industry from the outside.
Right. I can see you as like a Scotty Beam type personality.
She's a little more like high strung, I feel like, than me.
Well, but, not exactly her, but just her position.
Yeah.
Like, or Karen Civil or somebody like that.
I can see that. I could definitely see.
Yeah,
Karen,
I mean, so. I would love that. Like even what Nadeska does, like I respect what she does, like just kind of just being a part of it, the conversation. Like I just want to be a part of the conversation and just like be in a space where I'm just able to freely be myself. Like I don't have to like.
And I don't even mean to put you just. I know I just only named women, but anybody like that kind of position, man or woman, I feel like you'd be good for.
Well, thank you. Like, I'm great. Like, I was telling A.O. earlier, like, I always knew I wanted to be a part of the music industry, but growing up, I never knew, like, in which way, because I'm not a singer or a rapper or a dancer. So with podcasts becoming popular and blogging, and I found, like, my way in, but it's kind of just, I was starting to rethink it. Like, as much as I want the podcast to take off, like, I was starting to rethink, like, do I really, like, want to be so immersed in this business? Because just with, like, I think partly it's, like, the deaths and then just the drama. Like, I feel like reality TV and stuff has bleeded into, like, hip-hop and stuff like that. And it's, like, twerking, like, everybody, like,
but all,
surgery. It's just like it's just a whole bunch of stuff. Like, I don't know. It's like, ew, do I really want to be a part of
that? That all depends on what you opt into.
True.
I mean, like you said, reality TV. They could approach you with like, hey, you want to be a show? You could easily be like, no.
Yeah, like, and I'm not opposed to doing reality TV. Just not like loving
hip-hop.
You gotta
do it on your terms.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it would just be like me. I don't know how many views I get, but like,
yeah, right.
It would just be like an authentic thing. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. I just feel like it's just gotten a little too easy for some people to, like, get in the hip-hop space. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it, like, kind of, like, waters it down a little bit.
Now, who do you, like, who's a person who you think it was, like, easy for to get into the hip-hop space that you probably think, like, all right, if you ain't do this, then you wouldn't have been in here? If you can name one.
And not saying they're bad. Like right. Dream Doll. It's like, not, and actually, like, I don't listen to her stuff, but when right, I do right. hear, I'm like, she's not that bad. But just like somebody like that. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say Cardi B, because I do think she does have something special. But I think
she got that energy.
She definitely has the energy, but I do think that Love and Hip Hop did give her that opportunity. But she was able to, but she not whack with it, like,
right?
You know what I mean? So I don't really know.
I got one. I don't. It's hard for me because he clearly hustled to get the positions he got, but some of his takes, you know, like academics, for me is like. Sometimes when he talks, it's just like, yo, I could do your job way better than you.
Like, yeah, like, I feel like a hater. It's like, why are you there and not me?
Yeah, like, and it's like, it's hard to talk about him without sounding like a hater.
Yeah.
But it's like, you're so easy to, I feel like you have a position, but you have no respect to go with it.
They don't. Yo, I don't know nobody who really respect academics, yo. Like, for no, real,
he has a cult following.
I'm talking about people I know. I know there's people out there that
I'm about to say, because the young, like,
young people believe anything he's saying, respect him. It's like, but I'm talking about, like, yeah, like, people out there, yeah, they do.
How
people
did Joe and academics get together? Now that I think about it.
It's the perfect combination, yo.
It worked, though.
I watched that show so faithfully. Oh, my God.
It worked because I felt like Joe kind of in that realm when they was on Complex was speaking for the people like us watching. Yeah. Like, what are you talking about?
Right. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. That's why I loved it so much. But I don't know. I don't know. I will definitely just want to be a media person, not an artist.
Not somebody doing walkthroughs and stuff.
Yeah, like, I don't know. Like, I feel like I would thrive more, like, behind the scenes, more so. Just as I'm learning myself.
Yeah.
Like, I study PR and public relations thinking, like, okay, like, I want to be a publicist for a music artist. And that's somebody that's, like, in the field, like, hustling, like. But I think my personality may be more conducive to, like, the writing aspect, like more of the behind the scenes. I like the creative process of like coming up with the ideas and stuff right. like that, and writing and stuff like that. So maybe I'm more on the journalistic side.
Right.
But I don't know. I'm still hopeful though. I feel like we're all still young. I feel like it's never too late. There's so many people, mm-hmm. old people, older people, young people starting podcasts and stuff. Somebody listening.
Yeah.
My bad. What were you about to say?
No, I was just saying I'm agreeing with what you're saying. And it's just like, you know, just on the part of being still wanting to be, you don't want to be out there so much, you know. Like, you don't have to be out there so much to the point where it's like
you get mobbed. It's kind of scary just looking at everybody change. Like, this all spawned from, like, us talking about Summer Walker and, like, her... Because I was just saying, like, she didn't strike me as that type of person. Mm-hmm. That she just seemed like, oh, like, I don't really care. Like, this is who I am.
Right.
But then she, like, does all this extra stuff.
But you see how she keep trying to back away from music all the time or put these things out there. Like,
I think she's succumbing to the pressures of the industry.
I know. That's what I think, too. I don't really think she was ready for
this. She don't want to do the music, but she does want to do the music. She just wants to do it on her terms. And then, what you say, with the work she's getting done, and she talks all that, I don't want to be in the spotlight stuff, but she's so addicted to what everybody thinks of her that she still runs and caters to the comments. Like, she doesn't know what she want to do.
She frazzled, like.
Yeah, I've never been put, I feel like, and I've never wanted this, I'm not really a girl that's always been, like, the center of attention. And if I
likewise.
Am... Yeah, and if I am, me too. If I am, like, it feels weird. It's like, take it off. Like,
you don't want
to
be there.
You ever feel weird when people are like singing happy birthday to you? A little bit.
I know, I know the feeling you're talking about.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like the...
It's like, you don't know what to do. It's like,
you don't look for it, like that type of attention. So it's just like, you don't know whether to look at people or not. You're just looking down at the cake, just like, just staring at that jump.
Yeah, it's like, go ahead, I'm sorry.
I think industry-wise, I've always wanted to be behind the scenes. I never wanted to be in the forefront. Like, I started off wanting to be an engineer or like an A&R or... I wanted a record label at one point. Like, I didn't want to be an artist.
Right.
But I wanted to house talent.
Yeah.
With this. Like, I want to just have a platform. I don't need to be the star. I'm not self-centered. I don't ever need to be the star.
Right.
But I'd like to just be successful in the position that I hold. Like, with whatever it is. In those kinds of terms.
Yeah.
I could be, like I said, I could be managerial. Like, I feel like I could do that job. I could facilitate things for the person who's in front.
Right.
But I don't need to. I think I've always wanted to be successful in media, but still able to walk around a mall and just still be myself.
Yeah. I'm trying to be in a self-checkout, dog.
Self-checkout.
Yo, it's funny, like some boy, I was talking to somebody on Instagram, right?
But if this podcast pop, we will be seen.
Well, yeah.
Oh, I'm busting out the fur if it pop. Forget this conversation.
Oh, that's you. Okay.
All right. Like, no. I'm going to replay that clip. As soon as you like, I don't want to go on stage, I'm nervous. I'm going to be like, click. You were like, I'm busting out the fur.
I was on Instagram and I was talking to somebody. I heard his music on Instagram, and I hit him up, and I'm like, yo, I ain't gonna lie, like, boy,
who is this?
It was an artist on Instagram. I gotta go back and figure out what his name was. I don't want to get it wrong, but he had a Gold Roses freestyle, and I was like, yo, he was dope. So like, I kept looking at more of his videos, and I was like, yo, I straight up hit him up, was like, yo, this is probably some of the hottest music I heard from like somebody I never met or anybody in a long time. Like, it was
you
tough.
You gotta send that when you find out who.
Yeah, I gotta find it. But I was like, it was just tough. Like, I liked the feeling of his music and everything. His production had me with that feeling. Like, dang, I wish I made this beat. Mm. But I was talking to talking to him, and he was asking me He was like, what artists have you worked with or like worked with from your city and stuff like that? Mm-hmm. So I told him, and you know, I ain't work with like a billion people. Mm-hmm. But I told him somebody, and he was just like, he started apologizing because we just started talking. Mm-hmm. And I didn't like introduce myself or nothing. I was just telling him that I liked what he had. Mm-hmm. We was going back and forth having a conversation. Mm-hmm. So then I was like, oh yeah, my bad. My name is this. I'm a producer, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. So he asked me and I told him, and he was like, oh my God. He was like, yo, I'm so sorry, yo. He was just like, damn, like, I had no idea. Like, I was talking to somebody who produced it. And I'm like, yo, chill. Like, I was like, I'm not telling you. I mean, you asked me the question, so I'm telling you the answer.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not one of them people who's like, yeah, I did this. I was like, first of all, I straight up was like, yo, I have so much more work. I wanted to say so bad, like, yo, I still ain't shit. Like, I'm still like, I still ain't, like, I'm not like up here somewhere. But he was like, no, but that's like crazy. Like, you were this person. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, I guess. But of course, I'm not going to see that.
You know it from a side that he doesn't.
Right. Mm-hmm. So it's like, to him, it's,
you know,
like
the struggle,
yo,
of it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But it was like in the conversation a little bit, it seemed like he was treating me like he had to, like he had to respond a certain type of way, or he had to like hurry up and respond. And I straight up was like, yo, I said, I'm just a regular dude, yo. I was like, I was genuine about what I said to you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not hitting you up to try to just like get something from you. I was like, I really liked your music. I was like, if I really like something, I'll tell you that I really like it.
Collab,
I was
soon?
Like, huh?
Collab soon?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
What am I about to say? So
I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah, like I sent him some beats and everything. I sent some beats to hear and everything. So it was just kind of like
networking.
That kind of, but that kind of thing right there, like when it happened, that kind of made me like think again to a point where it's just like I would love to let people know, like, if they ever act like that, like, yo, even if I said I worked with, say if I was like, yo, I worked with Drake and I worked with Kendrick and I worked with this, I'd be like, yo, just know, like, you're gonna get the same type of me. I'm never going like I don't want to like ever flex on nobody. Them,
I'm calling you. I don't know, Aaron. Like I gotta say some respect. I gotta call Aaron. I gotta call you Aaron. Like yo. Pop up.
So for the people listening, though. Who have you produced for?
Right? I was like, he not going to name drop? Because now
people's ears are open now that you said that. Whoever's listening
like
to
who, you want me to get like the real
yeah,
answer?
Name yeah, name drop. Get real bougie on him.
All right.
Where the gunshot?
Because a lot of
we
stuff.
We don't get nuts. That's that other yeah. podcast. Right.
Well, disclaimer. Oh, a lot of stuff isn't even that. Like out. But of course, Young Chris, PD Crack, Stat Quo, and... Unfortunately, Stat Quo with Kendrick, but I never heard it.
Oh my yeah. god!
And he didn't put it out. I know it was.
I know
was,
you told me, but I keep saying, yeah. "Oh my god!" every time I hear.
I'd say it's there somewhere. But
he just sent you the track.
No, that's what I'm saying. He was just like, "Yeah, I ain't gonna drop the album, man. I'm gonna just do my family thing." I wanted to be like, "Yo, fuck the family thing." No, but yeah, it was yeah Stat Quo with Kendrick somewhere. Yeah, Young Chris, PD Crack. I think that's about it. Like, got close to doing it for Gilly, but we ain't never link up.
I think you was trying to get that game one at one point.
Yeah, the game. That's how I got Stat Quo though, because it was supposed to be game, but he Stat Quo and him was doing the joint thing, and then yeah. Stat Quo kind of just like became really like. Attracted to the beat, so it was really just him. Mm-hmm. I remember at one point, yo, it was a lot of stuff. Like at one point, it was supposed to be like I was talking to somebody that was in Trey Songz's team. This back in like 2011. That ain't never happened. That ain't never happened. And I think remember I told you around the time Dream Chasers 3 was about to drop. They was like, yo, Meek was in the studio doing a song with somebody to one of your beats or something like that. I'm like, where is that? So yeah. That ain't never happened.
Please stop, because now I'm getting angry. I was excited.
No, this was all really, and then I know it was one more. Oh, and I used to be going back and forth talking to French Montana's manager. I still remember the beat he liked and everything. Well, never
why,
happened.
Why not?
I don't know, because that was around the time I was on that website, Blaze Track,
yeah.
And I was submitting stuff, because that's how I met Stat Quo and them. That's how I started talking to Cardiac. And Cardiac had texted me and was well, he was
sounds like you need to hop back on Blaze.
Nah, ain't nobody. First of all, Blaze.
Back on Blaze. Whatever you said.
Well, it was like I was talking to Cardiac and like he was like he just straight up texted my phone and was hype as ever. Was like, yo, what's your musicianship like and blah blah blah. He would say he wanted to link up with me on some Maybach music stuff at the time. This was like 2012 and or 2013, and then. He was like, yo, have you ever, I still remember, he said, yo, what's your musicianship like? Like, yo, you play like keys or drums or something? Like, it really sound like you. And I responded. I was like, I don't play any of those things. I just kind of know how to, like, you know, put stuff on the screen and make it sound like I do. Yo, that was my last text to him. He never hit me back ever again.
You should have, like, why didn't you lie and say, yeah. They call me A Keys.
Because that's even more of a, yo. Because
then if you land someone, I'm like, now play the instruments.
Give me that computer mouse and I'll do it.
But you're in front of him now. So like, well, I'm in front of you now. No, I can't pick keys. So you got to listen to what I can do.
Dog, he couldn't even play keys. He had a boy with him that played keys. The boy Critical. And that's not a shot. But it's just like, you know, I'm just saying like, if that was the reason, I'd be like.
Right. I love but, sticking.
I mean, I don't know. It's just. I think what I hear people say what I hear people say all the time whenever I tell them stuff, like somebody I talked to yesterday, because I was telling them I went to A3C and stuff like that, yeah. So that we go there all the time. And I was like, yeah, the people who was judging it, I was like Black Metaphor was there and all that. Remember, he was there like 2 years in a row we went. Mm-hmm. And the second year, he was like, yo, I remember you from last year. He gave me his number both times. Never hit him up. Don't answer. And my only thing is, like, they meet so many people while they down there. And plus, those people are on, like, they're so high up. Like, his phone is probably filled with, like, Jeezy's and Games and everybody else. That it's like, when it's just, like, Jeezy, Game, 2 Chainz, Meek, Ayo, like, who is boy well, at the bar? So it's
you
like,
gotta
I mean,
stand out. So maybe you need to get 10 Chainz. Maybe they'll remember you.
But I mean, that's just how it works.
Like, save your number. His phone is 10 Chainz. 10 he Chainz. Be like, he's like, 10 Chainz. Who is this?
Young 10 Chainz.
Right.
2 Chainz gonna be irked. He gonna start a whole beat.
At least you know the producers in those positions see you as somebody who's a force.
I mean, yeah, and that's
yo. Once you played that beat for DJ Toom, and he looked at you like you.
Oh yeah, I forgot about him too. Yeah, yeah, I forgot.
So
yeah.
We have to. All right, we're wrapping
up. For those
who
don't know who Toom is, the song you would definitely know is Kanye. Can't tell me nothing. That's the producer for that.
So
yeah, so we're gonna wrap this podcast up because we have to come up with a strategic plan on how to really get AO out here because for some reason he's making all these connections and it's not sticking.
It ain't even.
We could have been on. I'm talking about we. Like I could make beats, but
nah, if I'm you could have been on.
And what you tell me before we got here? Who did you text that's working on the album that you've already named? But who was he with though?
Yo, Young Chris, Wale. First of all, Wale is executive producer Young Chris's new EP that he's done, and they was with Rick Ross in the studio playing it for him.
Your beat?
I'm hoping because I don't know if it was mine. I don't even know if I'm on this next Young Chris project, but we're gonna see because last time was a surprise too.
And he named Offscorecast.
Listen, I don't.
On Instagram, follow us Offscorecast on Twitter.
We'll be right back.
Yeah, this is this
after
thing,
I we, fight AO.
Yeah, we gonna sign out like that. Go ahead, keep signing us out.
Go ahead, yo.
If anybody has any questions, comments, or concerns, please email us at offscorecast@gmail.com. Please, I don't know, express yourself. Talk to us. Y'all don't ever talk to us. Y'all don't ever send us nothing. Y'all don't ever comment. Y'all don't ever do anything. So how about you take some time out of your day, formulate a question, formulate a comment, and drop it.
Drop. Stop playing.
While I go upstairs and figure out how I can take AO to new heights. Because apparently he has all these connects that never stuck.
Yo, it's just how it go. I ain't even discouraged though.
You shouldn't be discouraged.
I ain't never get discouraged.
The reason you shouldn't be discouraged is because at some point all these people was impressed.
Yeah. And I can honestly say that.
And so let you know what you're doing.
Yeah,
that's one thing I know.
See, Offscore, we just don't sit here and just talk about stuff. Like each individual person here has a talent to contribute.
Listen, look, we talk about music, we have fun every week, but as far as I'm concerned, we've been through we have not been officially in the industry, but we have been through the trenches of someone. Like, we've been to the festivals, we've been to the conferences, we've met the people. Like, we're in a position to speak to you this way. That's all I'm saying. And y'all can respect.
Well, not me. I just be hype because I ain't been to no festivals.
You've been to more. Cool. You've been to some festivals.
Well, I've been to festivals, but I ain't networked.
Jazz, you wouldn't be here if you wasn't right for the job.
Right. That's cool. If you haven't before.
It's cool.
It's gonna be.
Cause we on the rise. It's getting real hot outside. Well, it's getting warm.
It's getting real hot.
Keep the energy.
Well, it's getting warm, but it's getting hotter. Summertime's coming. We got some ideas brewing.
Oh, y'all
gonna
be brewing.
It's back.
Nah.
This is what makes us. This is what we are. You can hate us now. Let's go. Offscore is coming in the summertime. Let y'all know now. Yo, I'm tired of this. This conversation right done riled me
y'all,
up.
Y'all need to see this vein in Jazz's neck.
And I'm not veiny, okay?
She ain't veiny.
I got real tiny veins.
Tiny veins.
When I was getting blood drawn, the nurse couldn't even find a vein. But right
drawn,
now,
she couldn't find it.
Right now.
Yeah. Do it now.
Do it now.
Follow us now.
Now.
Tell your friends.
Friends.
Tell your family.
Family.
Tell your coworkers.
Coworkers.
Tell your baby mom.
Baby
tell your baby
moms.
Dad.
The drawn.
Tell your teacher. Tell your professor. Tell your boss, please. Go follow Offscorecast.
That's right.
On everything.
Everything.
Spotify, SoundCloud. Mm-hmm. What else are we
Apple,
on?
Google Play. YouTube.
Do it to the beat. do it to the beat. All right, I'm off this. But y'all know what to do after we cut this off.
Tell these niggas, Jazz.
I'm letting y'all know now. We coming in the summertime. I'm not playing with y'all
anymore.
And
we want comments and questions.
And we want comments,
ask
y'all.
Ask them questions.
Listen, if you're not gonna drop a comment.
First of all, she did the last. She said, "Yo, if you ain't gonna
send the Addy, we gonna slide." Okay. Rest in peace. Rest in peace to my guy, Father Pop Smoke. All
right. I like that.
I'm done.
I like it.
But for the last time, for the Oscar, I'm Jazzy Miotti.
I'm Ant.
Yeah, yo.
I'm scared.
And you're now unplugged.
Enjoy your weekday, weekend, workout, work, week, night. Y'all get it. I can't top what Jazz did. I can't. Yeah. There's no better
outro.
Yeah,
you're not going to top that. So I'm sorry. Let's just drop the mic now. Let's end it. Have a good night. Everybody, stay tuned for the next episode.
Bye.